everyone. Michael Gurley here with my daily podcast, though it may be evening when I record. I speak from my blog at michaelgurley.org. Titled this episode, What Are Thoughts? In my travels, I have been to parts of the world where the internet is not readily accessible, unless you're an area resident and pay for the privilege. In other words, no free Wi-Fi. Even visiting my sister in Dutch Harbor several years ago. Yes, it was in Alaska, Dutch Harbor. Essentially, there was no internet unless you had a paid connection. We've grown so used to being connectable to the world. In the palm of our hand, we hold the access point to the entire world. Internet news, knowledge, travel tools, ease of study, and social media. Without this access, we are often left to our own devices of finding a news source or computer access that hopefully gets us temporarily connected to the world, or thinking thoughts that come out from out of the blue and poof, gone to wherever, whatever place they came from. I'm left thinking early in the morning, but addressing it late at night. Without distraction, how does your mind work? The phone is connected as to the distraction of silly things. You name them for yourself, but my daily habit of playing Angry Birds Friends requires me to connect to the internet, and without the internet, the game is useless. I'm getting to the point of looking for a game that requires no internet to play, like Solitaire, so I can play and entertain myself without requiring a portal to the world. It's almost like you return to the yesteryear of doing math by hand. Wait, can you still do long division? How about flipping through card catalogs at the library? Wait, do they still have them? Or manually flipping through pages of research books instead of talking to Siri or Cortana and pick up a pen and write to record our thoughts? Lest I make this a more laborious thought than necessary, what I realize is that my mind is full of thoughts, oftentimes fleeting, sometimes lingering, and way too many times requiring me to dig deeply and ponder the results. Just about every day I think, this would make a good thought for a blog. My blog has become my platform for my thinking mind. Thoughts early in the morning are often the focus of the day's writing exercise. The concept of taking the thought, making it a part of my morning devotion, has opened up ideas that are worth recording and sharing. Future thoughts are recorded in various media, notepad, Word, Evernote, on my calendar, collected, collated, and eventually referenced in another blog post. In my older days of no computing device, my Bible would become the log of scripture thoughts as I read or heard from others. Scribble notes in the margin, pertinent words and phrases underlined or highlighted, and names of all those that I paid attention to as they spoke. This morning, while preparing my day, I had several thoughts plop into my mind, and then just as quickly they disappeared, not easily recalled. Where do these thoughts come from? Where do they go? They seem to come and go faster than I can pick up a pen, yet each one seems to be worthy of consideration. How do I slow down my mind and focus on one thing at a time? For the life of me, I cannot remember them. It's almost as the words of Job are swimming around in my head. From Job chapter 4, verses 12 through 21, it's a little lengthy, but listen to his opening phrase. Now a word was secretly brought to me, and my ear received a whisper of it. In disquieting thoughts from the visions of the night, when deep sleep falls on men, fear came upon me in trembling, which made all my bones shake. Then a spirit passed before my face. The hair on my body stood up. It stood still, but I could not discern its appearance. A form was before my eyes. There was silence. Then I heard a voice saying, Can a mortal be more righteous than God? Can a man be more pure than his Maker? If he puts no trust in his servants, if he charges his angels with error, how much more those who dwell in the houses of clay, whose foundation is in the dust, who are crushed before a moth? They are broken in pieces from morning till evening. They perish forever, with no one regarding. Does not their own excellence go away? They die, even without wisdom. I hear the whisper of these thoughts in my mind. Where do they come from? Where do they go? They often cause me to pause and consider them deeply. I'll remember this in a little while when I have time to write it down, and then I don't. That thought dies, and no wisdom is gained from the moment. Where do thoughts come from, and where do they go? When they linger long enough to notice, do you ever take time to notice them? How long will they stay if not entertained? Will they return, or are they lost forever? Do they simply fade into the background, feeling not welcomed, unwanted, and unconsidered? This thought has been with me all day long. I researched for someone to give me a hint of where thoughts came from, especially those random ones out of the blue. What causes them to pop, be there, and then poof, be gone? Maybe we will never know in my lifetime, but I keep hoping some of my research makes sense. Maybe, just maybe. Maybe on the other side, they will make sense. Just thinking today.